Good day, this is Brad Caleb, PhD, and my PhD stands for Post Hole Digger, for I continue to work on the proper foundation for the prodigal son and daughter, and that means that I am concerned. Did you know that there is an Amber Alert out today? An Amber Alert for the family of God? There is a destruction of God's family going on, and we are watching it on a daily basis in the news. President Trump, former President Trump, Trump that needs to do something else again to attract attention, because now he fired all his lawyers, or all his lawyers walked away that would help him for his impeachment, and he brings in some very questionable lawyers that don't even know what they're talking about, because this is not their territory. However, what I really am concerned about is about the Amber Alert. We know what an Amber Alert is. An Amber Alert is when a kid is kidnapped. And folks, that is exactly what I see happening with the body of Christ. You have been kidnapped by your leaders. People that were enthralled by Mr. Trump for whatever he promised them. And I am here to warn you. Folks, pay attention, because this is serious. This is a serious Amber Alert. Destruction of God's family, and it is the truth that shall bear witness of itself. For most of the body of Christ, the destruction standards from the end time is scary. It is a scary proposition. No matter what you are, who you are, if you're Jewish, or if you're Muslim, if you're Christian or an evangelical, or if you're just a politician, you ought to know what is going on. Just for your loved ones. A progressive realization of reality is better than relying on the news. Now my question to you is, are you familiar with the dog and the swine? If you're not, pay attention. Please hang around.
Thank you.
Yes, folks, the Amber Alert of the Body of Christ. Do you know why we have so much commotion going on right now in politics, in our daily life, and then we watch TV and then we see all the crap going on, fights there, war there? There are three words, three letters that you can put it under. And I know that some women are getting a little upset when I use this term, but it's called PMS. And I don't mean the women's disease. I mean politics. The M for money and the S for spirituality. Did you know that in all those three branches, three groups of people, or actually one group of people, the Freemasons, and they have all kinds of different people that are higher and lower, but maybe we understand a little bit more when I go back to the Templars. In those days, the Pope had caused something to move, to go to set and release Jerusalem. That was awesome. But out of those Templars, or before those Templars actually were in power, there was something that happened that most of us don't pay attention. At least not me. When I grew up, I was born in a Christian family. I was 6 years old when my mom passed away. I was the oldest of five. So we all went to an orphanage. It was a Christian orphanage. And I was responsible for a whole bunch of stuff. So when my dad remarried, when I was 13, 7 years later, he called us home. The only problem was I did not know what a home was. So I did not fit in very well. So shortly thereafter, I lived on the street. And from the street, I went up to the seminary, Bible school, preached in the gospel for 12 years, mostly prison ministries all over the world. But in reality, there were so many questions. One was, why is my mommy in heaven? I was 6 years old. My kids, my brothers and sisters were younger than me. The youngest was barely a year old. I don't know him. We grew up with the same name. But why? Why is she in heaven with God looking down on us while we need her? And that is how the animosity started. I was hateful. I hated God for the longest time because people were lying to me. But at that time, I didn't know. But I was very cautious, so I hid my feelings. I went into the library and I read every book that I could lay my hands on, whether it was a big 6-inch book or a thin one. I just read it. And with the reading came a lot of understanding. I've always loved books, but later on, as I became more familiar with life and when I had traveled around or could travel around and traveled around the world a couple of times, that is where I start to understand that everybody has the same problem. Whether you're white, whether you're black, whether you're brown, whether you're Chinese or Japanese or Indonesian, or if you're from the Indian family, meaning the native Indians in North America, it doesn't matter. We all have the same desire. Do you know why that is? Because we are created according God's image. God's image is so powerful. It has an imprint on our existence. And I know some of you that are listening, you don't even believe in God. But you wonder why you have compassion. You wonder why you have love. You wonder why you can stroke somebody and there's peace. And you wonder about so many things because the church has been misguiding you. Because remember, I mentioned something about the Templars. The Templars didn't get the power. There was something that happened, and it was Yeshua HaMashiach. Most of you know him as Jesus, because that's how the church likes to talk about him. They even tried to change his name. But reality is, it goes a little further. In the Garden of Eden, when Adam and Eve were created, God created them according to his own image. But what was the image of God? Hardly anybody dares to say or ask, what is God's image? Now, as I am making those videos and I'm talking about this, I was born in 1950. Today is 2021, just shy of a couple of days of the impeachment, second impeachment trial of Mr. Trump. So that gives you an idea that this year I will be 71 years of age. We were born, we were created to live forever. And yet we, as a society, are dying under a pandemic. Young people are dying, older people are dying, people that are of middle age are dying and people that are in and between are dying. Why is that? Is that God's fault? Folks, we created a society that is totally misconceived. We do not even understand who we are as a society. Do you realize what I'm saying? And Mr. Trump gets 74 million or 72 million people voting for him. A man that screws everyone around. When he has lawyers, he doesn't pay them. When he buys stuff from people, he doesn't pay them. He buys everything in debt. In other words, he owes banks millions, he says. But I tell you one thing, just before he got inaugurated, he went bankrupt. $1.8 billion, and Mr. Schulz had to bail him out. But Mr. Schulz doesn't have billions of dollars, so he borrowed them from his friend, a gentleman well known among the public. And he borrowed the $1.8 billion to bail Mr. Trump out. Mr. Trump has a disillusion to his family, to himself, but he refuses to accept it. But that is not the issue. The issue is, who are the enablers? The enablers are the body of Christ. And this is where the biggest confusion starts. Why are they so confused? Why are the leaders prophesying and telling their flock, this is what God shows me? And then we find out they lie. But we don't call it a lie because, oh my gosh, he's our leader. Well, this is exactly what happened to me, folks. I went through that same ordeal, but something happened. I had a friend that was a multimillionaire and he lived in a big house, 15,000 square foot home, which is 1500 square meter for the Europeans. And the beauty of it was that we worked together. At least I thought. We went on the bike together. We went all over the place. We spoke together. We motivated people. And we did business together. Till my friend discovered that my business started to grow. And all of a sudden I had millions of dollars generated in my business. And we were worth a couple of billion dollars due to some assets that I had been able to secure. And my friend wanted to have half of it. The problem that he had was that I am not used to dealing with people that want everything. Particular, he lived in a big house, he had everything, and I was just building up. And my idea was to help at least 100 people become a millionaire in their own right. And my friend was very upset about that because he wanted half of it. The only problem was he was a multimillionaire already, and I decided not to. And the date that we talked about this, he said, if you get through that door and let me refuse to accept my offer, you will regret it. You will see how much power I have. And at that time, I laughed because whoopee-doo. He said, do you know how much power I have as a Freemason? I am the head of the Freemasons. Big deal. Well, I must admit, folks, after almost 18 years in court, 8 years with lawyers, 12 years without lawyers, I spent over $10 million. I couldn't borrow a penny anymore from nobody. The collateral I couldn't put my hands on because that was what it was all about. And my friend was there to just demolish me. And so I had to learn the law. And I learned the law. I started to understand what Paul was talking about, the Apostle Paul. I'm not talking about the case because it's immaterial. I lost. I learned the law because I had to represent ourselves, my wife and I, without lawyers. So that meant I had to do what I always do, grab a book, read real quick, and start using it. So we became lawyers on our own. We won our first case to the... It was funny to see the attorney general. He was flipping because how could he have lost against us? And then he went to appeal. I'd never been in appeal, so I lost the appeal. And for 12 years, it was back and forth and back and forth. Now, normally in court, and particularly in Canada, you are covered on a charter right of freedom. Uh-oh, that sounds very solid. But if you are Freemason, you can do whatever you want to. They don't care. And so for 12 years, we were back and forth and back and forth. And eventually, I got sentenced for 6 years times three. I did 3 years of that till we found an appeal, and we won an appeal, and I finally could get out of this situation. Yes, I was bitter. Yes, I miss all the stuff that we had. We used to have the cars, the properties, and all kinds of other things. But mostly, I was also ashamed for my friends, because I had no friends left over. See, my friends came through church, through people that interacted with us, and we had a couple of hundred of them. When I was at the airport, chained as a criminal and kicked out of the country, deported, they call it, I was surprised. My wife and my two children were there, nobody else. And that really made me think. I'm not bitter, but I realized that our relationships had been destructed where somebody was there to claim it all. And this is where we want to start. You are in the same position that you don't know it. That is why I put an Amber Alert out for the family of God. Satan is after the destruction of the family of God, and that is why there is so much confusion. See, when I started to read the law and understand the law, I started to recognize something. My pastors, my teachers, my professors, they lied to us. They didn't tell everything. When I call it a lie, I should maybe say they left certain things out. Maybe they didn't know. But reality is, it was a lie, because when I used that and said, this is based in court, this is why I did this, they laughed about it, because I was told, although your intent was right, you are still guilty. Because the end run was, I was wrong, according to that judge. Later on, when we won the appeal judge determined that we were not wrong. But in the meantime, it took everything out of me. Yes, I went through a period of bittership, they call it that you're bitter, that you are PTSD. And then I kept on writing for 7 years, and that helped me. But also, what it did, I had to now focus on what is it that I went through. And that is what you're facing today. When initially Adam and Eve were born, they were created according to the image of God. Now, why do we have at the moment hardly any families left over? Because Satan bombarded the minds of men and women. See, God created us husband and wife. By the grace of God, I'm married this year 45 years. We had three children, one passed away. He passed away in my own arms, and that made me think about an awful lot. And we have two wonderful Canadians. But the beauty of it was, I learned that God's love is so great. And why can I talk about those things? Because I am set free. I want you to be set free. You are created according to God's image. That means you are like God. But you have to understand which parts. See, when I get married with my wife, or I live together, there's a difference. When my wife and I met, we were young, and she had been praying. She was in a situation where she really wanted to move on. And we went together, and we moved on. And in the process, we were told, well, why don't you guys live together? Check it out. See if it works out for a while. Now, we noticed that that is what the sisters did and the brother. And we don't know. I don't think they are married anymore. But we made a commitment, because that is how God works. Does it mean I'm perfect? Folks, I am not perfect. I am continuing to learn. But the beauty of it is, I did learn one thing, because my wife said yes and I said yes, we became like the Canadian geese. Canadian geese mate forever. And that is how we are. We are committed. My wife and I are committed to each other. No matter what we are facing, we are breaking through, because we are created according to God's image. See, when I am by myself, I'm only half. When my wife and I are together, we are a unity. We are a unit. And that is how God works. God is husband and wife. And when a man says, I am the man in the house, he is a fool. Because you don't understand who you are, my friend. And when a woman says in the house, I am the boss, C is a fool, because C doesn't understand who C is. C is created according God's image. It's husband and wife together. When the two of us get to know each other, and we get to know each other and understand that we are part of God, and when we are now together, now we are the fullness of God. But in the process of that fullness, we have to learn why Jesus said, follow this path. See, we are supposed to follow the narrow path, because society says, oh no, I'm the man in the house, you do what I say. And the woman says, you know what, get lost. I will raise my family by myself. That is why we have so much commotion. It's a destruction of the family of God. And now that I put out an Amber Alert, that means God is yearning for his people. He's yearning for his kids. He's yearning for you, my friend. And when you hear this, you might not completely understand what I'm talking about. And I wanted to make it more concrete on certain things. But I realized how important it is to understand that God's family is torn apart. You are part of God's family. It's not Mr. Trump. He is a fool. He acts like a fool because that is what he is, a buffoon. But you, the family of God, you are letting yourself torn apart because you want to follow a fool. Folks, it is said, but a fool says in his heart, there is no God. And if you say that in your heart, you don't understand who you are, because you are part of God. That's why you cannot avoid it. The frustration, the depressions that you're going through, because God created you to be something else. You are supposed to be according God's image. And God's image is perfect. You are supposed to live forever. You don't have to steal. You don't have to take it away. You don't have to force people. And that brings me back to PMS. You don't have politically to force people to do things that they don't want to do. You don't have to force people with money. Because I can tell you one story after another financially. How, what, and where. But it's not important. And then the S from spirituality, unfortunately, through this ordeal that I went through for the past 18 years, I learned that the church was never supposed to be the church. We were supposed to be on that small path, the way, the truth, and the light. That is the narrow path, folks. And you know why we need to be there? Because God's presence is there. We can be restored with God. And in his presence, we become alive. We learn, we move, we get wisdom, and we prosper. Because that is what God is. Everything is in God. But if we go the broad way, and now you say, but how dare you say that? My church, we praying, we laying hands. That's exactly what I'm saying. I've done all that thing. I have seen people heal. I was in the Jesus movement. But you know what happened? You know what happened? Where is all that? It is phony. People mean well, but it's still based on something of 325 AD, where the Emperor of Rome, Constantine the First, in a little meeting in Nicaea, where he determined, this is the church that you are going to follow, a Roman Catholic church. And he made a pagan Christian church. And he brought in false gods. And you are praying to false gods, folks. Yes. And I know that Mr. Hagee, Sid Roth, Paula White, Kenneth Copeland, Pat Robertson, and many, many, many others have been declaring, this is what the Lord says. But I say, folks, you are wrong. You should follow your insight and ask God for guidance. I can only spread the seed. I'm not the one that's going to teach you. God personally, he will teach you because he loves you. But you got to do one thing. It's like the prodigal son. When he discovered who he was working in a pigsty as a Jewish kid. See, I had a whole thing prepared for dogs and swines, but it's not important. I can tell you the spiritual aspects of it, but you are in reality hurting. You're dealing with a pandemic, and you know the pandemic is killing one after another. Why is that? We don't know. But we become weak because we have been giving in to the things of Satan. See, when we have the Ten Commandments, do you know that originally it was a covenant agreement between God and the Jewish people, but they refused? And so Moses went up the mountain, and when he came down and he saw them dancing like crazy, he just threw us Ten Commandments, because it was a covenant for the children of light. And when that broke, he went back to God. The God said, okay, I will give you the Ten Commandments for the children, for darkness. And that is what we are. And that Ten Commandments, you know what that means? Every time we break that commandment, one of these commandments, we owe Satan, not God. God had a covenant with us to share with us how it is going to be in the kingdom of God. But when you break the Ten Commandments for the children of darkness, we owe Satan. And this is what Satan is doing. He's calling in his debt because we lived like fools. We acted like fools. And there is a way back. We repent. We come back to the Father. And as the prodigal son said, Father, forgive me. And the Lord will say, praise the Lord. Come over here. I'm so grateful that you finally come and see who you are, because you're my son. And he forgave him. And the Father paid off the debt of the prodigal son. The Father is willing to pay your debt as the prodigal son. You folks, you do not have to pay, but you gotta learn something. You gotta wake up and smell the roses and recognize the position you're in. And I know this is not a sermon. This is just sharing something, because I went through it. 20 years it took me. For 60 years I was wandering. And now that I'm turning 71 this year, I know that I can live free. Did I make mistakes? Many, folks. I'm not perfect. Neither are you. But we recognize one thing. We still belong to the family of God. And that's why that Amber Alert for you. God is searching for you. And if you are willing to accept the fact that you goofed up, and God says, come, my child. And he will help you. He will teach you personally. He will guide you. And he will direct you so that you can be a fellow inhabitant in the kingdom of God. And that is what I love to see. That we can bring in more people in the kingdom of God. But that can only because we start to accept the fact that it was the Roman Catholic Church that made a deal with the Emperor of Rome. And that is where we, as the followers of Yeshua, the people that followed the narrow way, that followed the way, the truth, and the light, they got killed off one by one by one. And eventually there were only Goyim, people that were not used to knowing all the rules and everything from the Jewish people. And when the Pope got an offer, he couldn't refuse. He would be the man, gold and silver would be his. Guess who fell for it too? Many of our leaders today. They belong to the club. They are the billionaires now. Oh, this pastor, he's 100 million worth. That pastor. Folks, that is not what God said this for. Is money wrong? No. But don't come be fall victim to it. Understand that it's my God. My God shall provide. And all our needs. All our needs. But we got to learn something. We are the prodigal son. And when we get out of what you're in and you can focus on God, God can now teach you and he can guide you. And if you want more help, please contact me. I really appreciate it. And remember, tough times never last, but tough people, they do. God bless you. Bye for now.